here with you today to share with you a post review of this diamond painting kit called Private Collection by Julie Filipenko, licensed to Dreamer Designs. This is a Dreamer Designs kit. I purchased this kit in October 2022, and I finally just worked on it. If you want to watch the unboxing and me kitting this kit up, go to my previous video. I'll have it linked in the description box below. But I finished it. I started this on Thursday last week, and I finished it yesterday, which is Tuesday, so it only took me a few days to complete. It is a smaller kit, small-ish kit. It measures 60 by 60 centimeters. Do you mind? Get out of the frame, sir. Sir, you're blocking the post review. It is 60 by 60 centimeters. It has 60 colors and seven ABs. So this is the completed image. First thing that you probably notice, you're like, Bev, why is her skin pink? Why is her face pink? Why are her arms so pink? Because I have no idea. And I just realized after staring at this through the screen, Fox is biting her scarf. I just noticed that. That is very interesting. So anyways, this is the completed kit. You can kind of get a look-see from the bottom all the way to the top. 60 colors, 7 ABs. It is a round diamond painting. It was very quick to work on because you can tell that there's a lot of color blocking. Like that background there is color blocking. Her dress is color blocking. A lot of the frames where you see that whitish color, which is gray in real life, that is color blocking. So that's why it took me so short to do. Again, started on the Thursday, finished on a Tuesday. I had no complaints about the drills. Drills were fine. They're great. No complaints about the glue. The symbols were pretty easy to read. I believe if you watch my unboxing, the part of the video where I unboxed this kit previously, you'll see that it was very overly saturated. I was talking in someone's chat about this kit, and they said that Dreamer Designs has recently updated their diamond painting kits and updated their renderings and such, but let's take a closer look. So let's look at her skin first. So there's ABs in her face. I don't actually mind the ABs in her face, honestly. So if I tilt it like this, you can kind of see the ABs. I think it makes the skin look kind of cool that there's ABs in it. But you can see if you look up close, her face is actually, it's pink. And okay, so her face isn't that bad, but let's look down at her arm. Look at her arm, guys. What is going on? Why is it so pink? I don't know. So someone was like, you have an old kit, they've updated, blah, 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 which is great. I don't know if this kit, I haven't seen an updated version of this kit. The one thing is, though, when you're like, oh, they've upgraded their kit since then, it's like, what made this pinkness? Look at the pink. These aren't sleeves, guys. This is her pale arm. She's a pale white lady or a white girl. And this is literally, that's her arm. That's her hand. That is her arm. That's her hand. Why is it so pink and purpley? Like that's the real question. Like, okay, this is an older kit, I get it. But what made the designers or whoever, quality control people, inspectors, be like, oh yeah, this kit is good, let's get it into production? What made them think that this coloring was okay? I will put, let's do this. So I'm gonna put this off to the side, and then when I'm editing the video, I'm gonna add in superimpose image of the artwork. So you can see in the artwork, she's very pale. She's a pale girl. There, this is better. She's a pale girl. So why is her arm pink? This diamond painting kit is also available through Diamond Art Club. So it is licensed to Julie Filipenko, but Julie has made it available to Diamond Art Club and Dreamer Designs. So I'm going to edit in a video or a image of a completed diamond painting that I got from the Diamond Art Club website. Someone completed this kit, and you can see the side-by-side comparison of the Dreamer Designs versus Diamond Art Club kit. So what do you guys think? Like, from me looking at the image on the Diamond Art Club website of the completed kit, you can tell that her skin tone is a lot better in the Diamond Art Club kit. Like, her arm isn't as pink in the Diamond Art Club kit, and neither is her face. And, like, I don't think her face is that bad, but her arm is freaking terrible. It looks like she's wearing a sleeve. So that's, I don't know. Again, so this is an older kit. I cannot be responsible if you're like, I like this kit, I'm going to go buy it. Hopefully her arm won't be purple. I am not responsible if her arm is purple in the updated kit. I don't even know if they updated this kit. But I can say that it was, even though it was like a very short time to work on her, I did have fun. Admittedly, it was fun to work on. I liked the mixture of color blocking. I think if you're a big fan of color blocking and confetti, like you like the mixture of it, this is one of the easiest, this is probably one of the best mixtures of color blocking and confetti, to be honest. That's why it went by so fast. And if you are like me and you just like the process of working on a diamond painting kit, you'll probably like working on this kit. Like, it was enjoyable. I didn't have any fraying. I know that that was an issue with Dreamer Designs before. Their canvases would fray, but there were no issues of fraying. And I do like Dreamer Designs because they end the diamonds or the drill field a little bit before the end of the image. So you can see that there's like a border around here of the image itself, but the drills don't extend to the very end of the artwork. So I really like that. And it's nice because the glue ends like right where the drills end. So you're not going to have to washi tape your canvas. Usually for me, because I have a black cat, there's always hair on the edges of my canvas. And with this one, there's no hair because literally the drills cover the entire glue area, which is very cool. I probably, like, after working on this, I have another Dreamer Designs kit. And yeah, I can honestly say I would work on another Dreamer Designs kit. It wasn't terrible to work on. It was fun. My only issue is that her arm is purple when it should be white because she's not wearing sleeves. I really like this image. I think it's fantastical. It's like, did she kill these butterflies with this shotgun? Who knows? I really like where the ABs are. So there's ABs throughout the entire image. It's like they're kind of scattered everywhere, which I really enjoyed. I like the bow. I like the rendering. Like I think the rendering is really cool. It came out pretty crisp, which is neat. And yeah, the rounds were great to work with. I used a 15 placer and a 10 placer for the most of this kit. And yeah, I don't know what else to say, but my only gripe is that her arm is purple. I said that a million times, but I think if the updated kit doesn't make her arm look purple, I would definitely recommend grabbing this kit from Dreamer Designs. If her arm is purple still in the Dreamer Designs kit, I highly recommend going over to Diamond Art Club and grabbing this kit from them. I'm not sure of it, if it is still available, but yeah. purple arm, that's all I have to say. Thank you so much for watching my quick post review. Let me know in the comments down below what you think of this skin tone. Again, let's look at it up close because that's all I'm focusing on. Purple arm. But the rest, like the fox, look how cute that fox baby is. The fox is great. Her face isn't too bad. Purple arm. The butterflies are really cute. Like if you look at this, you can see the AB in it. I really like the placement of the ABs. I was really impressed that there were 7 ABs, and the drills, the canvas itself, were great to work on, except for the oversaturation. No issues with the symbols. Grab this kit if you want to. That's all I gotta say. And if you're new here and you like diamond painting videos, go ahead and click the subscribe button. I post new videos whenever I feel like it, and I do go live every Tuesday at 6 p.m. Mountain Standard Time, so make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!